For the next week.
Kalau memang dia kepala dia meja ada aku kena dua meja duinan. Awak bila suara aku motor sebab ada kahana shop sama aku membayar bayar sigaret. Kami kau mahu meja lah everybody. Kami mahu disini sal. Sama sama orang looks like semua dead. Everybody start laugh on us. Well, look like Greg not here. Old man dead last night on the road. So far that be here. Everybody they are mourning and tightly but we not really hear the rest of it. So the two men are dead.
This community is a quiet community.
Yes.
And as far as I can say, the first day of the year, all that people here.
Sad man. Sad. Right now, I cook and me I go hungry for this idea. Because I decided that I'm not hungry today and I get up and cook and I miss me come buy a cigarette and get in new, so I just go back to the car for school. Food not cook, not need of the car and let's see me because I can't eat for this idea. Hearing this thing and go say, what the man they were dead and the man they were say, come here, I don't know them. And I never really know them as this, I don't look for this. So it's sad and shocking to me.
I just heard this morning that Cadian, known as Red Boss, died. I don't know what caused it, but I only hear that he's dead.
Where are we now? Where is coming to call?
Cornwall Mountain, Fraser Land.
How do you come in to feel at this time?
We are very sad, very, very sad at this moment. I tell her, it's just like my son. I raised Cadian when he's a little boy, going to school. Always bring them to school. She always call me mom, my second mom.
Pleasant good afternoon, my viewers. All of my new subscribers, happy new year. Coming straight out of JNN newsroom. So my valid viewers, we are now currently in the new year where we can say welcome to 2022. But unfortunately, the mayhem still continues. Even though we are in the new year, doesn't mean there are new things. The same whole things brought over from the whole year into the new year. Today is the 1st of January 2022. A two-vehicle accident happened on New Year's Day. Three people taken out in St. Anne. Three persons lost their lives along the Londonderry main road in St. Anne's early this morning when a Toyota Coaster and a Toyota Axio motor car collided. Both of them were runaway Bay address in St. Anne. The third victim has not yet been identified. Brown was reportedly transporting staff member from the Rhea Hotel in Ocherias to Runaway Bay when the crash occurred. Around 12:10 a.m., Gilbert McLeod, otherwise known as the owner of the bus, said he and Brown shared the responsibility to transport hotel workers on the late shift. I heard that two cars were coming down and they were trying to overtake, and I heard my driver tried his best to take away from them, and what happened, he couldn't even help himself. They hit him and put him on the other side. McLean told the reporters that he last spoke to Brown shortly before 6. The bus owner was devastated when he arrived at the scene last night and realized that the driver has been taken out. There was no report of any serious injury to the other occupants of the bus. We've been warning people from last year up until this year about the driving hard situation and the overtaking of traffic. Come on, guys, man. Slow down. If you reach 10 minutes late, it won't take your life. But don't reach at all. That's the tragedy. St. Thomas woman charged with the death as man succumbed to stabbing injury. 33-year-old Cynthia Rowe of Friendship Pen, St. Thomas, has been charged with the December slap away of a man in Duane Pen in the parish. Milton McPherson, 66, a transportation assistant of Tamlin in Marant Bay, died a week after he was juk-juk-up during an argument with Rowe over payment for a service. You know what that means, my viewers. Mama give him the sitting and he no let off the cash pa mama, so mama get boisterous and plan for just juk-juk him up. You don't know the thing, but Jamaica this. Me not have to talk out loud, you don't understand. Rowe is allegedly to have used a pair of scissors to juk-juk up McPherson in his neck on December the 12th. He collapsed and was transported to the hospital where he succumbed to his injuries on December the 19th. Rowe was apprehended by the police yesterday. Her court date is being finalized. So right now, my viewers, yesterday the police sent out a briefing telling persons that to desist from the illegal gun salute of the New Year's last year. It wasn't that serious, but you know, anything can happen because gangs and gangs are at it for the last couple months of last year, head to head, a lot of person get slapped with. So right now, child among 5 injured in illegal New Year's gun salute. A child is among 5 people injured in a separate New Year's gun salute celebration in St. Catherine North and St. Andrew South Police Division last night. It is reported that the child was at home on Nelson Road, Kingston 11, about 2:30 a.m. when screams were heard coming from his room from several explosions. The child was transported to a hospital where he admitted. Earlier, about 5:07 a.m. on Oxford Street in Spanish Town, St. Catherine, a man was sitting at his gate when loud explosions were heard. Shortly after, he felt a burning sensation in his back. A woman who was in her bed at a nearby property also felt a burning sensation on her left knee and realized she was torn up. Both were transported to hospital where they were admitted. The St. Catherine North police further reported that about 2:30 a.m. an elderly resident of St. John's Road in the parish was at home when several explosions were heard. The elderly woman woke up to find that she had been shot. She was transported to hospital where she is undergoing treatment. The police are warning citizens that gun salutes are illegal and very dangerous. Among anyone with information about these and any other incident are urged to call the Crime Stop at 311 or the police 119 emergency number. My viewers, it is very, very serious, because the old saying goes, what goes up must come down. And it's not all the time a man I go put the rifle or the handgun or whatever he's firing upwards in the sky. Sometimes him turn it crossway, so, or sometimes him just point it so and just fire. Because these gunmen don't care. These 87, these criminals don't care where they point their weapon. They are just saluting for themselves, for the amount of person with them take out, or whatever case the salute may be. So please guys, desist from doing things like these. These 5 person could have lost their life, because the bullet could have lodged anywhere. New Year's Day, double slap away in Westmoreland. The police are now probing a New Year's Day, double slap away in Westmoreland. The police say the men were leaving a property when explosion were heard. Investigators were called and the wounded men seen. They were taken to hospital where they both died while undergoing treatment. Viewers, last year, this year, it doesn't even matter which year it be, whether 2010, 12, 15 or 16, it is the same thing. It's the same thing over and over. We need to dress back and take a look back and realize that some of these things are unnecessary. Most of these things can be stopped. Most of things can be put a stop. Whenever somebody in the community, whether a gangster, do something, we all shut our mouths and act as if we don't see. Whenever the police come and dealt with the situation or take out that lone criminal, we block road and we this and with that, and we say I'm innocent, and with this and with that. Come on, Jamaica, we need to put those foolishness aside, because at the end of the day, a few own family or friend can lose their life just the same as how that person take out somebody else and the cop get information and take him back out. The police can't get information unless we provide the information to the police. So my valid viewers, my subscribers, just continue to like, share and subscribe to the movement. Turn on your post notification bell. Leave a comment down below in the comment section. Join JNN News Channel family, so you will be a part of all of the updates, the daily updates and whatever happenings in Jamaica. Because there's a lot going on and we want you guys to be updated for each happenings. So turn on the post notification bell when you subscribe. Stay tuned for more updates and for the channel to be bigger and better. We are on the road to 20,000 subscribers. Help us on that journey. Bless you.